In this video, we will simulate the precipitation of cementite during tempering of an iron, manganese, carbon steel. We'll use three growth rate models from the precipitation module to consider three interface conditions: the usual ortho-equilibrium condition, the parae-quilibrium condition, and a smooth transition from the parae-quilibrium to the ortho-equilibrium condition. We consider all three conditions because the growth kinetics of cementite initially follows the parae-quilibrium condition due to the fast diffusion of interstitial carbon. It gradually transforms to the regular local equilibrium condition, which we call ortho-equilibrium, so that substitutional elements can reach equilibrium partitioning at the migrating interface. You can learn more about all of the growth rate models in the precipitation module in the online help by searching for growth rate models. This calculation uses demo databases and only three elements, so it can be run by anyone with a license for Thermo-Calc 2023A or newer, including those with the free educational package. The calculation is based on example P15 of the examples included in your software, but in this video, I will show you how to set up the calculation yourself. To begin, open Thermo-Calc in the graphical mode and click on the precipitation template from the home screen of the software. This will load the nodes we need for this type of calculation. From the Databases package drop-down menu, select the Demo Steels and Fe Alloys package, which will load both a thermodynamic and kinetic database. Next, select the elements iron, manganese, and carbon. Our system is now defined, so right-click on the precipitation calculator node and select Rename. This example will have three precipitation calculators, so we will rename them so that we can tell them apart. Name this node OE for ortho-equilibrium, then click OK. From the top, we will leave the composition unit as mass percent, but we will set manganese to 1.96% and carbon to 0.61%. This automatically sets iron to 97.43%. Set the matrix phase to BCCA2, then click Show Details. Change the grain size average radius to 0.1 micrometer and the grain aspect ratio to 100. This is to match the experimental martensite grain sizes and shapes that are used if you run the included calculation file. Set the mobility enhancement prefactor to 0.008 and the activation energy to -70,000 joules per mole. This is done so that the bulk mobility data of the BCCA2 phase included in the database can be adjusted appropriately for diffusion along martensite grain boundaries. Now we will configure the precipitate phase. Set the phase to cementite and click Show Details. Change the nucleation sites to grain boundaries. We will use the default settings for everything else in this section. But before we move on, open the drop-down menu for Growth Rate Model. Here you will see the various models that the program offers. We will use the simplified model for this calculation, which considers the ortho-equilibrium condition. Under Calculation Type, leave Isothermal selected. Set the temperature to 923.15 Kelvin and the simulation time to 1 million seconds. Next, we will set up the other two precipitation calculators. Right-click on the precipitation node and select Clone. Right-click on the new node and select Rename. Name the node PE for parae-quilibrium condition. We will leave the matrix phase as it is. Since we cloned this calculator, the settings match those in the OE calculator. Under the precipitate phase, click Show Details. Set the growth rate model to parae-eq for parae-quilibrium. Leave all of the other settings the same. Under calculation type, set the simulation time to 5 seconds. We will run a shorter simulation for this condition to save time, since the parae-equilibrium calculations are relatively time-consuming, and we only need the data from the beginning of the simulation. Finally, right-click on the OE precipitation node again and select Clone. Right-click on the new node and select Rename. Name the node PE-OE, representing the smooth transition from the parae-equilibrium condition to the ortho-equilibrium condition. Once again, we will leave the matrix phase the same. Under the precipitate phase, click Show Details. Set the growth rate model to PE Automatic. The PE Automatic model in Thermo-Calc enables the smooth transition from the parae-equilibrium growth rate model to the simplified growth rate model, or OE. The rate of transition process is dependent on the relative differences in diffusion between carbon and substitutional elements, as well as the differences in driving force between para-equilibrium and ortho-equilibrium. Our calculations are now configured, so we will set up our plots. Right-click on the Plot Renderer node and select Rename. Name the plot Mean Radius and click OK. Right-click on the node again and select Add Predecessor, PE. Right-click on the node one more time and select Add Predecessor, PE-OE. Our plot will now show the results from all three simulations. We must now configure the plot for each calculator. On the OE tab, set the axis variable to mean radius, cementite, nanometer. Set the axis type to logarithmic 10. We will accept the default for all other values. Click on the PE tab, and we're going to set the same settings here. The axis variable will be mean radius, cementite, nanometer. Set the axis type to logarithmic 10. Finally, click on the PE-OE tab and set the same settings. The axis variable is mean radius, cementite, nanometer, and change the axis type to logarithmic 10. Our plot is now set, but we also want to plot the precipitate composition, so right-click on the Plot Renderer node and select Clone. Right-click on the new node and select Rename. Name the node Manganese in Cementite. Then click OK. On the OE tab, set the axis variable to precipitate composition, cementite, manganese, mole fraction. Change the axis type to linear. Under the x-axis, uncheck the box next to automatic scaling and set the limits from 0.01 to 1 million, stepping at 1. Now click on the PE tab and set the same settings. The axis variable is precipitate composition, cementite, manganese, mole fraction, and the axis type is linear. Under the x-axis, uncheck the box next to automatic scaling and set the limits from 0.01 to 1 million, stepping at 1. Finally, click on the PE-OE tab, and we're going to set slightly different settings here. The axis variable is the same, precipitate composition, cementite, manganese, mole fraction. Change the axis type to linear. Under the y-axis, uncheck the box next to automatic scaling and set the upper limit to 0.14. Under the x-axis, uncheck the box next to automatic scaling and set the limits from 0.01 to 1 million, stepping at 1. Our plots are now set, so right-click on the My Project node and select Perform Now. Your calculation may take several minutes to run, so pause the video until it's complete. Once the calculation is complete, two plots will appear in the results pane. From these two plots, the smooth transition from para-equilibrium to ortho-equilibrium is clearly visualized. In the mean radius plot, you can see that the PE-OE curve initially follows the para-equilibrium curve, but gradually it shifts and follows the ortho-equilibrium curve. In the manganese and cementite plot, you can see that in the PE-OE curve, the composition of manganese in cementite is initially the same as that in the matrix, a non-partitioning parae-equilibrium condition. Gradually, it reaches the equilibrium composition at a later stage, a fully partitioned ortho-equilibrium condition. We hope you found this video useful. We are constantly working to create new videos, so if you have suggestions on videos you would like us to make, please leave us a comment. You can find additional videos on our website at thermocalc.com in the video tutorial section.